they're doing is they're bringing in high school.
Thank you. Thank you. Thank you. Test. One more time. We are going to tell you a true story. These are events that actually occurred on Lake Michigan in 1873 during a supply run by boat from Beaver Island, 70 miles south to Traverse City. Our story is based on audio field recordings from the Library of Congress made in 1937 of oral accounts from two residents of Beaver Island who had personal knowledge of the events herein related. One was Dominic Gallagher Jr., 70 years old at the time of the recording, whose father, Dominic Sr., is the central character of this story. The other recording is of Andrew Gallagher, who is not related to Dominic, but is the nephew of a Captain Roddy, who is also a key figure in this story. For those of you familiar with Northern Michigan, by the 1930s, this nephew of Captain Roddy, Andrew Gallagher, owned the barber shop by the bridge in Charlevoix. Our telling of the story will be through the eyes of the son, Dominic Jr. Many of the words you will hear will be actual words transcribed from the 1937 recordings. Our presentation will also employ a Lake Michigan sea shanty called the Gallagher Boys, also captured on the 1937 field recordings, written just 1 year after the incident in question by a Dan Malloy, a former whaler who was also a resident of Beaver Island and who personally knew all involved. Members of the audience will have the opportunity to sing along on the shanty by joining in on the repeat of the one-line refrain. Each verse, with two exceptions that will be obvious, ends with two statements of a refrain. I will sing the first, and you may join in on the second. The words are for to cross o'er Lake Michigan where the stormy winds blow. Let's practice. For to cross o'er Lake Michigan where the stormy winds blow. Try it. For to cross o'er Lake Michigan where the stormy winds blow. One more time. For to cross o'er Lake Michigan where the stormy winds blow. Please be aware that these words change slightly toward the end of the piece, but I cannot tell you what those words are at this time, lest I spoil the outcome. was in 1873. I remember because I was 6 years of age and I was born in 67. But even though that was some 60 years ago, I still remember the day Papa left with those Gallagher boys to sail to Traverse City. It was in October of 73, we left Beaver Island and had a calm sea, bound away to Traverse City, our destination to go, for to cross o'er Lake Michigan, where the stormy winds blow, for to cross o'er Lake Michigan, where the stormy winds blow. As I said, on the boat with those Gallagher boys was my papa, Dominic Gallagher Sr. Now, there were a lot of Gallaghers on the island in them days, but Papa was no relation to the Gallagher boys, Johnny and Big Owen, that we know. Well, it took about 10 to 12 hours to sail to Traverse City, and they got there just fine, and got their supplies, and they headed back to Beaver Island the next day. We left Traverse City at 9 the next day, and down to Elk Rapids we then bore away. We took in our store, and to sea we did go, for to cross o'er Lake Michigan, where the stormy winds blow. For to cross o'er Lake Michigan, where the stormy winds blow. Of the Grand Traverse Bay, we carried all sail, and to sea we did go, for to cross o'er Lake Michigan, where the stormy winds blow, for to cross o'er Lake Michigan, where the stormy winds blow. The weather turned. Bad weather, you understand. Real bad weather. A gale of wind. The seas were running awful high, waves scratching right over the top of the gunwales. They only had a 24-foot boat, you see, a small open boat in high seas during a gale. Johnny shouts out to encourage his crew. My brave lads, now be steady and true. Stand by your fore halyards, let the main halyards too. There's a squall on Lake Michigan. The boat, she's a-running. Ignore the hard gale. Thank you. and they was all lost. We heard the next morning that the boat was lost. Well, my mother knew Papa had left with them, so when the news came and the report that all hands was lost, I remember Mama was crying, and I had six sisters, and they was all home, and they was all crying. That night, we held a wake over Papa. And all the next day, all the neighbors come and stayed with us. Our friends was all gathered round Mama and me. When Papa comes through the door, he's come from sea. We laughed and we cried, how our faces did glow. He's come home from Lake Michigan, where the stormy winds blow. He's come home from Lake Michigan, where the stormy winds blow. So what happened that Papa got home alive was, there was this Captain Roddy, and he and Papa were great friends. And Captain Roddy was in Traverse City that same day as Papa and the Gallagher boys. Now Captain Roddy could see that the weather was gonna turn, and he knew it wasn't gonna be fit for them to go out in that small open boat. Well, Captain Roddy, he goes right down to the dock, you see, right to their boat, and he says to my Papa, he says, "Dom, you ain't crazy, are you, to go out in that boat today?" And Papa says to him, he says, "Well, I tell you, my wife is sick, and I want to get back home." Well, Captain Roddy looks him straight in the eye and says, "Now look here. Better for your wife to be without you for 2 or 3 days than to be without you forever." Now that's just the words he spoke. And now Papa told me this himself. He told me Captain Roddy took him by the shoulders and physically pulled him off the boat and restrained him so he couldn't get back on board. Now that's a fact. So Papa and Captain Roddy wait more day until the weather clears. And they come home together in Captain Roddy's vessel. And when they come to St. James, the harbor here on the island, they hear the news that the Gallagher boys' boat was lost and that we held a wake over Papa the night before. And so Papa and Captain Roddy are rejoicing that Papa didn't come in the boat that was lost. And being good Irishmen, like almost everybody on the island, they celebrate with a little whiskey on the way home. So when Papa comes through the door, he starts to dance, so glad he has been spared. He has always been a great one for singing and dancing the old Irish songs and dances. And so that day, and most of that night, instead of a wake, well, we have something more like a wedding, with dancing and singing and instruments and rejoicing. Come all ye neighbors, McMerry with us and join our jubilee. We'll dance and sing and dance some more, our hearts are filled with glee. Come drink the health of our papa, make music 1, 2, 3. We will raise a toast and we will boast that he's come home from the sea. Are filled with glee. Come drink the health of our papa, rejoice in this you know. He's come home from Lake Michigan where the stormy winds blow. He's come home from Lake Michigan where the stormy winds blow. He's come home from Lake Michigan where the stormy winds blow. He's come home from Lake Michigan where the stormy winds blow. He's come home from Lake Michigan where the stormy winds blow.
after me.